Well, joining us now is Dr. Scott Weslow, cardiologist with BayCare. You're here to tell us about some new research that says aspirin is not for everyone, right?
Correct, yes. Aspirin is back in the news, right?
Yes.
Seems like it's always there. But the reason aspirin's back in the news is because a recent study suggested that a good number of people out there are taking daily aspirin and probably shouldn't be.
Right, and they just start this because they assume, you know, their parents had heart problems, their parents had heart attacks, so they just started on their own.
That's correct, but the interesting thing about this study is that it showed that even 10% of people who were told to take aspirin by their doctor shouldn't be taking aspirin.
So what kinds of things, I mean, if you're taking aspirin, you shouldn't be taking it, what kinds of side effects does it have?
Well, aspirin is a blood thinner, and there are a lot of blood thinners out there, and aspirin's no different. Any blood thinner can cause bleeding. And the thing we worry about with taking daily aspirin is bleeding in your GI tract and bleeding into your brain. Those are serious bleeding issues. We're not talking about a little scratch that oozes a little bit. We worry about major bleeding, and aspirin can cause that.
Okay, this might be a dumb question, but when you say aspirin, give me some brand names. Like, is Tylenol aspirin? Is Advil aspirin?
It's
is Aleve aspirin? Is
Bayer?
I mean, obviously, it's Bayer aspirin.
Bayer is the most common kind of aspirin, but aspirin has been around forever. It comes in generic, and it comes over the counter, of course. It comes in different doses. It comes in a baby aspirin,
the
full dose aspirin, which is 325.
Okay.
But different from Tylenol, like acetaminophen or something like that, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Different from those.
All right. Different from those. So you got to be careful when you're looking at the labels.
Question, right?
No.
Not at all.
Okay,
thank
That's
you.
A good question to ask. Because like
thank
pregnant
you.
Women cannot take aspirin. You know, they only have certain things that you can take.
Correct.
Perfect.
Yes.
All right. Good to know. Yep. All right. Now you sent us something. We have this video here. It is a heart risk calculator.
Correct.
Okay. So to explain this for us a little bit.
Sure.
We tried to get Mino to do it. He didn't want to do it.
I didn't know my cholesterol. I didn't think those numbers went high enough.
I can tell your cholesterol by just looking at you.
That's what I said. Yeah. He was drinking a Monster Energy drink and he's like, what's my cholesterol? I'm like, I don't know, but maybe we shouldn't be doing this.
Right. So the purpose of this calculator is to determine if you should take aspirin or not. And aspirin is taken to prevent heart attack and stroke, but it also causes bleeding, as we talked about. Mm-hmm. So you have to make sure that the benefit you're getting from it, the prevention of heart attack and stroke, outweighs that bleeding risk.
Okay.
And this tells you basically what your risk of heart attack and stroke is, so that'll tell you if you should benefit from aspirin.
And just plugging in some information into that calculator, I mean, it's really simple. It's like age, female, male.
Gender, cholesterol, blood pressure, things like that. And then it comes up with a number. Now, it's going to give you a percentage, okay?
Yes. Yep.
The percentage that it comes up with is the percent chance that you will have a cardiovascular event in the next 10 years.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I did this earlier. Mine was less than 1%, so I think I'm okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You are good.
Good deal. All right.
No
but
aspirin
it's
for you.
No aspirin
How
for
about
you.
Me?
I'm not sure. We
We're
going to
have to do his later.
Energy drinks, good or not?
What's the word?
Moderation.
Moderation. Okay. Definitely not for kids, though.
No, I would not.
Not
take it
for
if you're kids.
Right.
Kids should have enough energy, right? They're kids.
They're okay. They're never tired, so they shouldn't need it. All right, perfect.
Thank you
so much, Doctor.
My pleasure.
And for more information about the study and for a link to that risk calculator, just visit our website, NBC26.com, and click on this.